lecture series on organization leadership, a subject, a HR elective paper for MBA students. And the topic that we have for today's discussion is Favourableness Contingency Model. I'm Professor Sarita from the Department of MBA, Don Bosco Institute of Technology, Bangalore. To understand the model, the Favourableness Contingency Model, it is important to understand what exactly is the matching between the leadership style and the situational favorableness. Understanding the model. The Favourableness Contingency Model was created in the mid-1960s by Fred Fiedler, a scientist who studied the personality and characteristics of leaders. The model states that there is no one best style for leadership. So it states that there is no exact rule or this one to be a leader. It is basically a matching between the leadership style and the situational favorableness. So instead, a leader's effectiveness is based on the situation. This is a result of two factors. It could be the leadership style and the situation favorableness, later called the situational control. So it could be weighing in this side or the other side, either the style of leadership or the situation, how favorable it is for the leadership style. Identifying leadership style is the first step in using the model. Fiedler believed that leadership style is fixed and it can be measured using a scale he developed called Least Preferred Coworker Scale. So LPC, the Least Preferred Coworker Style of Rating. The scale asks you, think about person you have least enjoyed working with. This can be a person who worked with you in any company before or any institution before. So you got to rate him in this scale. It could be either like unfriendly, meaning one, or you rate it on a scale of 8. So friendly scoring is going to be 8. So unpleasant means 1 and pleasant working with him means 8. So you just see the scale, how it going to be. So the least preferred coworker scale, when you give the ratings and you add up the scores, if the scores are least or low, that means this leader is not a relationship-friendly leader. He is a task-oriented leader. So here, if you see, the model says that task-oriented leaders usually view their LPCs more negatively, resulting in a lower score. So Fiedler told this, LPC leaders, low LPC leaders are task-oriented leaders. But they're quick to organize a group to get their task done, but not for the relationship building. Situational favorableness. Next, you determine the situational favorableness of how your particular situation is. This depends on three distinct factors. Leader-member relations. This is a level of trust and confidence that your team has in you. A leader who is more trusted and has more influence within the group is in a more favorable condition to get his work done. Coming to the task structure. This refers to the type of task you are doing, clear and structured, or it is going to be vague and unstructured. Unstructured tasks or tasks where the team and leader have little knowledge of how to achieve them. They view it unfavorably. Leader's position power. So the amount of power you have to direct the group and provide them reward or punishment depends on your leadership style. Applying the Favourableness Contingency Model. First step is to identify your leadership style. Think about the person you have least enjoyed working with, either now or in the past. So you can rate the person whom you worked with in currently or in the past, and what exactly was the score you would give to him. So the least that you enjoyed working with him, maybe he was not supportive or things like that. So rate your experience with this person using the scale that was given before. According to this model, a higher score means that you are naturally relationship-focused leader, and a lower score means you are a task-focused leader. So if you give more scores, your total scores are high, meaning you are a relationship or a rapport-building person as a leader. But if you do not view it in a positive way and give negative scorings, you are a task-oriented leader. So identify your situation. Answer the questions. Are leader-member relations good or poor? Is the task you're doing structured or is it more unstructured? Or do you have little experience of problem solving similar problems? So if you do not have much experience solving those kind of problems, it's going to be a little tough. So that situation is going to be a little peculiar or different for you. Do you have strong or weak power in controlling your team? So all these factors is going to decide your leadership style. Determine the most effective leadership style. Figure 2 tells you, shows a breakdown of all the factors we have covered. Leader-member relations, task structure, leader's position power. The final column identifies the type of leader that Fiedler believed would be the most effective in each situation. So the relations, the task structure, and the leader's position power tells you what kind of a leader and what is the most effective leader attributes are. Coming to the task structure, if it's going to be structured, meaning you have worked on the problem before, you know how to solve the problem. As a team, you know to work with it. So the leader's position power is very strong in giving reward or in giving punishment. So the most effective leader may rate a low LPC score because it is going to be a structured program they're going to do and he's having a very good position power. For instance, imagine that you have just started working at a new company replacing a much loved leader who recently retired. You're leading a team who views you with distrust. So the members of the teams are not trusting you basically. The task you are doing together is well defined and your position power is high because you are the boss now and you are able to offer reward or punishment to the group. So in this case, you may not be giving a very great scores for your relationship with the team because you are dealing with a problem that you are already aware of and you know how to solve it. And you have the power to reward or punish your people. So criticisms, if you see in this model, there are some criticisms of this model. One of the biggest lack of flexibility and the natural leadership style is fixed. The most effective way to handle situations is to change the leader. For instance, if a low PLPC leader is in charge of a group with good relations and doing unstructured tasks and she has a weak position, then according to the model, the best solution is to replace her with a high LPC leader. So instead of asking her to use a different leadership style, it's better you change the leader. There is also an issue with the least preferred co-worker scale. If you fall near the middle, your score is not very clear. So this is all about the contingency model of Fiedler. If you have any doubts, you can ask me or comment me in the section below. Thank you. Thanks for watching.